I got so many ill memories with you. I can tell you the craziest shit. Me and you went to Brazil. And Brazil, you're like a god there. They love you in Brazil, right? So
I love Brazil, man. Big shout out to everybody in Brazil, man.
No, Brazil loves you. And I remember we go in the fanciest hotel. We got security. And we just sitting there. And the promoter comes and he goes, now listen. You know, you guys, I just want you to know, you're not performing in the beach or nothing like that. You guys got hired by the biggest kingpins of the favelas.
Right, of Brazil. Yeah.
And I'm sitting there with you and I'm looking at you and I'm like, wait. And he says, hey, they just killed 62 cops last weekend in the favela. They went to war with them. And I'm like, yo, what the fuck?
That was my man. The dude, man, I think his name was Don. That was my man, yo. He looked like Jay-Z. He looked like the Brazilian like Jay-Z.
Remember the dude? He made a sign of a gold Desert Eagle. You remember that?
He had the gold Desert Eagle for me. Well, the mother, yo.
I'm telling shit. I don't know if you saw, right? So basically, everybody had a gun. Everybody had a gun.
Everybody
with a gun in their back. So I go, so not us, over there, the people there. So I don't know if you saw this when we're leaving, because you got to walk up the favela, and then you got to walk out. It's like one way in, one way out. If you from Puerto Rico, it's like La Bella. And as we walking out, you see the whoever was security or whoever had, they were piling up guns on a car. Like, you know, like, giving back the gun for the night, like if they were, like somebody just gave out guns to the crew. Yo, if the other crew come, be strapped. But at the end of the show, give me my guns back. You know what I'm saying? So they was piling guns up on the car. I was like, yo, I'm gonna get the fuck out of here.
Yo, it was the craziest night, yo. That shit was crazy.
The security, yo, John. Let me explain this to them because they're not understanding what we talk about, John. Y'all, John, we walk in. It's the movie. Y'all got to go see this movie called City of Gods. And so the favela, when I got there, they thought, I'm going to tell them the whole story. You just stop me.
Yeah, you tell them the story. I'm going to light this up right here.
Hey, yo, light it up. Yo, Ru. So we get to Brazil, and I think we're going to be doing like spring break. The beach party, Rio de Janeiro, or something. They said, yo, look, y'all got hired by the three biggest bosses in the favelas. Favelas is you check in and don't check out. Like, if you're not welcome there, you're gone. And they explained to us, I don't know if you remember, they explained to us that they had killed like 60 cops that week in the favelas.
Yeah, yo, let me tell you. My security, the dude that I, the police niggas that I had with me, they wouldn't go up there, crack. When we got to the guard for the chick, they're like, we don't go up there.
We had security for no reason, so they made us walk up. And then when you walk up, there's like a checkpoint. And at the checkpoint, the guy doing the security was a little kid, no older than 13, 14. He had a blunt in his hand, and he was telling me, stop. Like, for me to light his blunt, and he had a rocket launcher. Shit that could
Word
blow
mother.
Up a plane that was heavier than him in his fucking hand.
Listen, I'm going to tell y'all, all the people watching crack ain't like that shit, yo.
My asshole was this tight.
Crack ain't like that shit.
My asshole was this tight. Yo, let me tell you.
I'm like, crack, we good. They love us here. Crack, we good.
Yo, Rube, when I walked away from that guy, my head was like, yo, all money ain't good money, my nigga. I was just walking away like, yo, this is crazy, man. Like, I never seen a grenade launcher in my life.
Yo, crack, let me tell you some shit. The first time I went there, right? Because that was the second time I had went. The first time I went.
They love you there, Rube.
Oh, they love me there. The first time I went, crack, we had to get out the bus and walk up to the favelas. So niggas was out with guns anyway. Niggas was out in the shit. So the nigga that was walking me up, he had the nine on him. And he just like, back up, back up. He telling niggas to back up in the windows. In the back. Yo, nigga, favelas is a different place, nigga. But I love the favelas. I love Brazil. Brazil, we love y'all.
We love you, Brazil. Muito bem. Now, though, Benny, let me tell you something. My man, when I tell you, me and you performed, right? And it was the most beautiful. It was like the sun was coming up because it was late. They made us perform like maybe 4 or 5 in the morning. But
we was in Mangueira. We was in Mangueira. We went to both. We went to Mangueira and we went to Damn, what was the other favela? It was Mangueira and
we went to 3 of them.
Yeah.
Hey yo, but let me tell you something. They said like this. They told me, they gave me like a manual. They said, if a guy talks to any man's wife, he has the right to shoot him and not argue with him. He won't even argue with you. If he shoots you, you know, you got to handle that because you talk to the married man's wife.
Uh-huh. You know
what I'm saying? So I'm over here telling, and the women in Brazil, I got my wife and my daughter right here. They are beautiful. So
tell the wife and daughter, I said, what's up, Brad?
They love you, Ja Rule. But listen, sure, man. Tell the family I'm telling them knucklehead in my crew, like, bro, they're going to shoot you in your face. You talk to these girls in here. I'm letting you know now. Don't talk to
listen,
them.
We've been through it, nigga. Brazil was ill. Africa was crazy. Let me tell y'all, my nigga Crack didn't fly before we went to Africa. He didn't get on planes. He only did buses. So I said, Crack, you got this big-ass record, What's Love? This shit is taking over the world, my nigga. And you missing all this money overseas. Crack said, what kind of money?